can't kill the Rasta man at all. Them can't kill the Rasta man at all.
Because all the people of no color have all the money.
See.
You understand what I'm saying? Yeah. So you, if you look at the business financial, like you go to the Observer business, you might find a little man that's black.
Wow.
But the whole business class here is of no color.
I like how you said that.
That's
no color.
No color. That means
that's nothing them, just white.
That don't white. Yeah.
So that's like I'm saying, I'm focused on what this project is about, and that it links people to understand, like, we need to bond business-wise. Because that's what I'm saying, like, if we are going to use Rasta brand and it's going to be global, I want to make sure that it empowers the black youth of America. I want to make sure that. I don't want to be sophisticated just going to the, you know, whatever those people are. You understand what I'm saying? I want to make sure that all them people that are in prison, because so many of us are still
in prison.
Because of that.
You understand what I'm
saying? I'm also trying to get Obama this. We're reaching out. Because when he was president, he went into federal prison and he released a lot of non-violent drug offenders, which were mostly black. So that was something he did before. He released a gang of people.
Exactly, but those gang of people are gonna buy, that was my thing about Marley Natural, being owned by privateer.
Mm-hmm. Which, and then former DEA people
and all of that, right?
Part of the
for me,
crazy.
Growing up in the urban and seeing everybody with a Dutch master.
Yes.
And knowing that those are the ships that brought us here as slaves.
Yeah. It's like them purposely, they're just like,
let me tell you something. I was going to try to find a place to talk about that. But yo, but peep this here. So the reason, this is the thing, because I was around in the 70s when this started. When the Rastas had come and brought the weed gates and stuff. What happened was the reason blunts got into hip hop is, and it was really happening in Brooklyn when I was coming up. And the first thing they did was White Owls. Once they began to get respect for the rosters that came in, you know, from the posses that came up and set up the weed gates, they had weed 24 hours. Then when guys began to respect their style, the Earthman shoes, diamond socks, that whole look, they then started to emulate. They saw them rolling weed out of frontal leaves. They smoking weed, like where they get that shit from? So black Americans didn't know where to get that. So the closest thing was a cigar. So it started with White Owls. And then it went to Philly Blunts. Then it went to El Producto. So you hear him on various you know, like let's smoke an L. You know, smoke a White Owl. Then in different parts of the country, they had other kinds of cigars like Swisher Sweets.
That's Georgia,
that's
Atlanta.
All started from trying to emulate Rastas with frontal leaves. Then the rapping made it more popular in the video, so then everybody wanted to smoke like that.
And who owns Swisher Sweets and who owns all them companies?
All of them. We don't own none of them companies, obviously.
Well, you know, that is what I like here, Sono, right? With young entrepreneurs. We own our own companies. Right, and we have the knowledge and we know exactly what to do.
Exactly.
We can make shatter, we can make crumble, we can make THC, pure THC distillate, right? Pure CBD distillates, terpene extractions, whatever it is.
Yeah.
First of all, that's why the council to determine that if you are using Rastafari culture in any way to sell yourself to the consumer, then we must have a say. You understand what I'm saying?
Yeah, no,
we must
have a say. Did you trademark anything?
That's what we're doing now under the United Nations. Because no culture in the world created itself to be trademarked. You understand what I'm saying? It was, we weren't in the business of being the
biggest. It just happened.
Right.